when they're in harmony, you will have a healthy body, healthy everything, okay? Okay, I still see some faces that are unclear. So, when kidney yin is exhausted, okay, mm-hmm. the kidney water will fail to restrict the heart fire. Right? That makes sense. Okay, when you don't have enough water, you can't restrict the heart fire. That would lead to hyperactivity. Right? It's very simple. Or heart fire. Right. Meanwhile, this heart fire will not be able to be directed downwards mm-hmm. to warm what? To warm the kidney water. Okay? Therefore, the upper part of the body has too much what?
Heat
and suffering from like a hyperactive heart fire, and the lower body is suffering from coldness, right? Cold and they say coagulation, okay? So this would lead to problems like, and remember we're talking about heart, so what are some of our symptoms for heart? Insomnia, okay?
Insomnia.
Yeah, mental confusion, you could have delirium, okay? Did we say palpitation?
Mm-hmm.
You could have some semen emissions in severe cases. Okay. Okay. Now I know that we're reviewing this and talking more about all of this, but it's very, very important. Now, how about with the liver, the kidney with the liver? Okay. So we know that the liver stores blood and the kidneys store essence. So, how do they help each other? Because remember, in the five elements, here we have between the liver and the kidney, we have a mother and child, mutual generation type of relationship. Okay, so the liver promotes flowing, okay, while the kidney promotes storing. Okay, so the two organs belong to, we have the upper middle jaw, which the liver and the kidneys belong to what jaw?
The lower jaw.
Even though the liver is located in the middle jaw, physiologically, pathologically it belongs to the lower jaw. Okay. Okay. So we know that the liver promotes flowing, and its function is to store blood and it regulates the supply, which helps to ensure what kind of blood circulation, right? Blood circulation, yeah, okay. Okay. So I think we've covered almost. Have we covered the organs and the relationship, and you understand the Mingmen? And just reread your notes, and we will come back to this when we speak about the kidney. Okay. I'm just going to ask you to fill in the blanks. I'm going to read a couple of things for you, and just so you a little bit of a summary. The kidney is to govern the growth and development of the body with its role in storing and controlling what? What's another name for essence?
Jing.
And it also dominates development, and what comes before development? Reproduction. Okay. Jing consists of prenatal. Prenatal and postnatal, which are stored in the
kidney,
good, and which together, as a whole, are known as kidney essence or kidney jing. Unlike qi, this jing circulates in longer cycles. For women, it's how many years?
7.
And for men?
8.
Good. And the function of this jing, of essence, is to promote what? Three things.
Growth.
Reproduction.
Development.
Okay, so how can you remember that? That's first you have reproduction, then growth, and development. Okay?
Congenital Jing is called what? Pre-heaven. Okay, mm-hmm. And acquired Jing is post-heaven. And that's produced from the spleen, stomach, Gucci, Cucci, okay? All three types of essences play a part in determining growth, development, sexual maturation, and reproduction, as well as in the aging process, okay? Okay. What are the four aspects of kidney? We have kidney jing, which is essence, kidney yin, kidney yang, and kidney qi. Okay? Now, those aren't the syndromes that I told you before. Those are just the aspects, okay? Regarding essence, they say it's cooked in the water using the fire to produce life-promoting qi. That's quite nice, isn't it?
Mm-hmm.
Cooked in the water using fire. Okay. All of the body's function needs
warmth.
Good. And this heat is provided by kidney qi and the gate of life, or the minister fire. That's found where? It's the space between the
two kidneys.
Left and right kidney. Right. Kidney jing is the foundation of all yin and yang aspects of the body's organs. Okay, and kidney yin and yang is the primordial yin and yang, the root of yin and yang, okay, to all the tsang organs. Now, kidney yin does what? When usually you go into nursing homes and people are, you know, if they were 6'4" and now they're 5'4". Okay, so they're like a prune.
Contraction.
So kidney yin moistens, okay, nourishes the whole body. That's why the Chinese, we want to take a lot of herbs and foods that nourish kidney yin. Okay, so you don't dry out like a prune. While kidney yang provides warmth and promotes this warmth throughout the body and the tissues. When the kidney receives fluids, it can be one and two. What can it be? It can be clear or turbid. Good. So the clear fluid is sent upward. Okay. Mm-hmm. What is the other organ that is in charge of whole body water metabolism?
Whole body?
Yeah. Sen Chao. Yeah, water metabolism. So the clear fluid is sent up upward through the Sen Chao, and it moistens the lung for the lung to distribute the rest of the body, while the turbid, right, is sent downward and is to the bladder and is excreted through the bladder. Now the water gate is also responsible for the opening and closing. Okay, of what some people will call the drainage ducts, okay, or the sphincters. Okay, primarily the AB, anus and the bladder, okay, AB, anus and the bladder, which rely on kidney qi. So if your kidney qi is weak, you're going to have incontinence because it's not strong enough. Okay, the sphincters are very loose. They're just going to let everything out. I think we've more than covered, you know, the basics for kidney. Are there any questions? Okay, I think we've covered it. Okay, so now we're just going to finish off, and the kidney is the, probably like I've told you, it has all these relations because it is both water and fire, and we have two of them, yin and yang. And it's just related in so many ways because of the warmth that we need in the body, which it supplies, also because of the kidney essence. How important is that? Okay?
So the urinary bladder is important, but we don't have, we're not going to spend as much time on it. Where is the urinary bladder located? Okay, what's its paired organ?
Kidney.
What's its peak hour?
3 to 5.
Okay, so that was a little slow, so let's do it again. Lungs, large intestine, stomach and spleen. Heart, small intestine, ubi, kidney. Pear, sanjiao, GB, liver. Okay, good. Okay, so what are the peak hours of the UB?
7 to 9.
Which one?
7 to 9 p.m.
UB?
Yeah, UB.
3 to 5. Color?
Black.
Good, 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 good. Starting point? Everybody point to it. Inner canthus, and it ends on the small toe, lateral side. How many points? 67. Good. And 64, UB64 is the
UN
point. And it's a good point to resolve dampness for the lower jowl. Okay? Now the pathway, it starts, as I said, at the inner canthus and ascends to the forehead. Okay? It joins the governing vessel meridian. What's another name for the governing vessel meridian? Governing, not conception.
Oh, sorry, do.
At the vertex, and one of the branches goes to the temple. Okay, then it descends down in four columns down the posterior aspect of the neck, runs down along the back, enters the body cavity at the lumbar region, lower back, connects with the kidney, okay, and joins the bladder. The lumbar branch goes down the gluteal, and ends at the popliteal crease, and the branch from the neck goes down the back, okay, and descends at the lateral end of the little toe. Okay, this is just a very kind of just a little bit of a description. You're going to have to go back, study it, and actually draw pictures. That way you can understand, oh, now I understand why the urinary bladder is connected to the kidney. Ah, it's actually going right in there. Okay, mm-hmm. So although we know that it starts here and ends there, we also have to know where it goes in the muscles and where it goes in its, where the branches go, where they stop. Okay? Okay, what's the physical branches? Same as?
Same as the kidneys.
Okay, and... Okay, so let's just talk a little bit about the bladder. What's its main function?
To remove water.
Store and eliminate, right?
Yeah.
And excrete. Okay. And it removes this water through the transformation of qi. Okay, it transforms clear fluids from the small intestine into urine. Okay, which it then stores and then excretes. Now, the kidneys provide the qi, the kidneys provide the heat for this bladder process. Okay, the organs that are significant with the controlling of the urination are the small intestine, because what does it do? It helps move fluids to the lower burner, mm-hmm. Right? The small intestine. It also helps to supply the clear parts of the fluids to the bladder. Okay? Heart qi, what does the heart qi have to do with the urination? It has to descend. Yeah, it has to descend in order to help with the excretion of urination. Lower burner is necessary to ensure that the water passages in the lower body are open and free. Now, what does liver do? Liver qi, what's the main function function of liver qi? So it's smooth, the qi, okay? So there's no blockages, no stagnation. And finally, lung qi promotes the transformation of fluids and excretion of urine as it descends, comes down. Okay. Now, the mental aspect the bladder. Suspicion, this is where jealousy comes in. Bladder, okay? Grudges, negative emotions, okay, that's the mental. And it's just like, you know, when you're holding in stuff, when you're holding in, you know, it's about letting go. Things come up in life, let it go. Resolve them as they come, but don't hold in, okay? Okay. So we know that there's a relationship with the between the kidney and the bladder. What is it? Because they're interrelated, right? Mm-hmm. Exterior-interior relationship. Okay, so the kidneys and the gate of life are needed because they provide
the warmth,
chi and heat, the warmth, good, to the bladder, so it can do what?
Store and excrete.
Transform the fluids and yeah. However, just know that the kidneys do not need to rely on the bladder to excrete its dirty fluids. Okay? Now, on a more psycho-spiritual end of things, the bladder. Often when women break up with someone, usually they may get cystitis. Okay? And again, that's that whole infection, this whole ability of irritation, where you know it's some find it more difficult to release emotions. Okay, that's just on a symbolic level. It's not true, but there have been a few studies, and usually this, you know, how come I didn't get it? You know, why am I getting it now? Because you're more vulnerable, you're holding on. And remember, everything is interrelated. So our stress will manifest in a place in our body that's maybe more weak at the time. Okay, so if you're not being able to voice your truth or things don't have closure and it's all stuck, it might not be the cystitis, but it'll be something that'll manifest in your body because we need to release, you know, mm-hmm. in every way, in our mouth. I mean, think of in early days, even if we think of sound therapy, in the early days, you know, they did all this. Christianity has confessions. We, you know, when they didn't have that, they, you know what it's like to walk around in guilt. I mean, and some people, you know, it's a surprise birthday party. You can't walk around because you have to tell everybody, oh, there's a surprise birthday party for my husband. And you can't. You're just dying to that, you know. So also Freud. You know, he was a smart man. He just took it from Christianity, the talking cure. You know, just, you know, have the person lie down on a couch and have them talk. Okay, and today, you know, we have therapists for everything. And not just in talking, but in expressing things through art, art therapy, mm-hmm. dance therapy. So different things to express these unexpressed emotions. Sometimes they're so difficult, even with children, abused children. I'm wondering about that case, the one in Germany. That was a horrific, horrific case. What? No, the one where they had 30 years or 28
the
years.
The woman who escaped.
Oh. With all the children.
That's another one.
Her
now
father.
In the States, hey?
Yeah. I mean, it's. Hey, did you hear about them?
She was in the basement, locked away.
The same as the one in Germany.
Yeah.
And
no, the one in the States was in the basement. She was in a backyard in like a
and
shed.
And she was getting her, like her father made her pregnant, so she actually gave birth to her own.
Two children.
Two children.
No. We don't know. No. We don't know anything. They're not. I don't know if you've seen pictures, but they're having a lot of therapy. But I mean, these are severe cases. These are totally.
Crazy.
Oh God! No, I think it's more
sick.
Than selfishness. Yeah, I mean,
I
think
it's
the wife
sickness.
In this case.
Definitely.
But let's just go on. So you understand the psycho-emotional aspect. It's not needed for TCM, and I haven't seen many books delving into this. But because everyone in this room is talented and has other modalities besides learning TCM and Chinese medicine, I think it's you know, you can take it and make it your own. You know, it's as simple as if you've got, you know, okay, frozen shoulder, we know what points. What point on the stomach is good for frozen shoulder?
58.
What's your frozen shoulder point?
GB 58.
No GB.
No
GB. 38.
Yeah, 38.
Yeah, okay. My goodness me. Okay. And also LI 11, LI, you know, the LI meridian. LI, yeah, okay, okay. But on another level, when you're speaking with the person, you know, oh my God, you know, my daughter did this, my husband did this, I don't know what I can do, and this financial, you know, foreclosure and everything, and, you know, and I'm a single mother, and I just cannot, you know, and of course, you know, she's carrying everything on her shoulders. So this is what we're, I don't want to leave this part out, but it's not going to be a big part of your exam, although I would like it to be. Okay, so the relevant psychological points of view, and then we'll end this part of our study, is that a person prone to deep depression may have an ability to cope with life changes and situations. Urination signifies the process of flowing, right? Urination. And the ability to cope, and in all categories, mind, body, and spirit. So what does the pelvis area symbolize? Having to stand on your own 2 feet. Good. Excellent. And not being dependent on someone else. Okay? So being able to support yourself. Okay? Got it? Mm-hmm. Okay, so if something is weak there, a lot of incontinence, and we have that when people get older, they're weak, and they, you know, often a fear comes, oh my God, I'm 60 and I'm alone. I want a life partner, or So, you know, everything is holistic. Everybody's different, and you can see what's happening on their own. Okay, the urinary bladder is located in the lower abdomen. It is a full or hollow capsule.
It's a hollow.
Okay, and it is a hollow capsule underneath the
large intestine,
the intestine,
kidney, and in front and below of the intestine. It has how many points? Peak hours are between
3 and 5.
Good. UN point is
64.
Upper end, its upper end is connected to the kidneys by way of the ureters. Okay? Ureters. Its lower end is connected to the
urethra.
Right, which opens to the external genitalia. Good. It is in the lowest position. Okay. Here, the remainder of water is gathered after metabolism. Its main function is to store and excrete the urine. There are actions of the spleen, also the lungs and the kidneys, to help transform the water fluid in the body fluid, supplying the whole body with nutrients. Okay. After the metabolism, there is remaining fluid which is transported back to the kidney and the urinary bladder. I know we're talking a lot, but try to stay with me. The qi, the urinary bladder qi, should be strong, because if it is weak, it's going to affect that opening and closing manifestation, and can create things like what?
Incontinence
or enuresis. Damp heat, what can damp heat do? It can easily invade the urethra. You know, urgent urination, itchy, smelly, painful urination. Okay, that's all we're going to do today on the yin organs. So we have covered the heart, the liver, the lung. And today we covered the spleen, kidney, and the urinary bladder. Okay, so do you think you've learned something? I think you've got it. We went through and repeated quite a lot, and you've learned a lot from your other courses. But although it's simple, when you have to try to explain this, like, oh well, what happened? You know. So go back to your notes, read it over, and it'll become more clear. If there are any questions, let me know.
So somewhat, but only common.